Alright, what's better? I'm Pathfinder here, and today we're going to be talking a little bit about what's going to come in the future for Killing Floor 2. Okay, just before I hop right into the news, I do want to give a massive shout out to Davin Murray for pledging $5 on the Patreon. I mean, you guys and your awesome support. Davin, thank you very much, and that goes to each and every one of you who actually, you know, even like considered checking the Patreon. It really means a lot if you even just go and just pledge a dollar or something. Okay, just to be clear, I'm not the dude that goes around telling people that you need to like donate to keep the channel going. I just appreciate each and every one of you who go like that extra step to like, you know, support my content and shit like that. So I really do appreciate each and every one of you, man. And Davin, thank you very much. That's really kind of you, man. Okay, I do believe it's freaking news time, so here we go. Tripwire has recently just started the What We're Up To again, and I usually go and do these videos like later on when there's like more stuff announced, but I just decided to go for it anyway, see if you guys enjoy it or not. So here we go. So what has Tripwire announced? Well, they posted on Steam Community Classic Time To Vote Again. And there we see some information about an upcoming weapon, which is going to be the M99 AMR. And on top of that, they made another survey, or should I say a poll, for weapons that we would like to see, and these are the new weapons. So we get to pick the Fire Axe, the FN-Fall, the M32 Grenade Launcher, the Mark 23 Pistol, and the Thompson SMG. Okay, I'll just be talking about these weapons a little bit later on, and now let's hop into some real announcements. So they posted there what we're up to, you know, a couple of days back, called a prestigious upgrade. And there we see a lot of information, so let's just start from the top. So we get to see perk prestige. Yep, you heard me right, you will now finally be able to prestige your freaking perk. I mean, it took long enough, man. I don't know why they didn't just do this from the beginning, but hey, better late than never, am I right? And I'll just talk about this in more detail later on, and now let's go to another announcement, which is the weapon upgrade system. Well, I don't know how I feel about this one, to be completely honest, but hey, let's just go to the last announcement and then we're just going to talk about this in more detail. And here she is, the character that everyone wanted from the start, Mrs. Foster. Okay, that's pretty much all that we currently know. Now I'm just going to be talking about these points that I made in more detail and I'll give my opinions on these. Okay, first of all, let's start with the weapon that will come in this upcoming update. Now, I don't know if this will be the summer update or are they planning on something before that, but nonetheless, I'm just going to be saying the upcoming update because I don't know for sure. Okay, the M99 AMR, a sniper rifle from Killing Floor 1 that can only be bought probably for the boss in Killing Floor 1. It was like incredibly powerful if you did do that initial headshot, and at the same time, the whole sniper reload cost was 5,000 for some reason. In Killing Floor 1, I felt that it was like incredibly awkward to use it because the only thing you could carry with that, you know, sniper rifle was the 9mm pistol, and that's pretty much it. I really do hope they're going to make it a little bit different for Killing Floor 2 than Killing Floor 1, because in Killing Floor 1, like I said, it was incredibly awkward. And I just hope it won't become a weapon that is only going to be used for like 2 weeks after its release. Hint, hint, a hemogoblin. I mean, let's face it, this game will look incredibly cool with like a bolt-action freaking sniper rifle. Now, I just hope they're just going to like expand on this, like make like a rifle or something. Maybe some World War II weapons, who knows, that would be actually exciting as hell. Okay, now for the other weapons that are in the poll. And you're probably wondering, Pathfinder, what the hell did you vote for? And I'm just gonna say M32, because I do like my grenade launchers and I do like my nuke machine. But at the same time, I mean, the FN-Fall, I kinda want that shit also, because that shit was just like my favorite weapon in Killing Floor 1 for the commando, right next to this car. But yeah, I will put the poll in the description so you guys can go vote on whatever the hell you wish, but my vote just went for the M32, I just want that quality perfection weapon in this game. And my real question to this like poll and everything, I know it's supposed to be like what the community wants most, but my question is, why not just add everything? Jesus Christ. Okay, now that we have the weapons out of the way, it's time for the perk prestige. Finally! I mean, this will at least be something that will keep the players going in the game, especially console players, because they don't have the luxury of having the Steam Workshop. Rest in peace, consoles. So, prestiging a perk will not change gameplay, you will just have to level up again, and it's completely optional, and if, however, you do prestige, you will be rewarded with increased leveling speed, additional wall dodge, and a fancy new icon for your perk. And on top of that, you're even going to get some fancy-ass skins for your knives, so you can show off. I mean, I really love these news, man, because it's completely optional and it just adds that, like, additional replayability to the game. And I just hope they will add multiple stages of prestige, though, because I don't want to just, you know, prestige once and that's it. If I would design this, I would make it so that you can prestige at least 10 times or something, and each time you do so, you receive more stuff. But the only downside to, you know, these, like, prestiging things is the perk leveling maps, so rest in pieces for that. But hopefully, Tripwire will keep that in mind. But yeah, other than that, the prestiging gets a thumbs up from freaking me. Now let's head into the weapon upgrade feature. Pretty much what this does, it makes crap weapons turn into reasonable weapons. I mean, they kind of nailed it with the picture they're showing off, one of the most, like, useless-ass weapons in the game, the Medic SMG. I mean, there's, like, no real point of using it for the Medic anyway, but it's kind of reasonable for the SWAT, you know, I'll give it that. But yeah, anyway, this feature will give you a button at the bottom, and upgrading will take dosh, and it will scale the weight. I just wish that the gun would, like, actually physically change a little bit as you upgrade it. You know, if it would add, like, a different barrel, or a scope, or a handle, and so on. I mean, that will be just, like, the best. But most likely that will not happen. So, what will upgrading your weapon actually do? Well, currently the only thing that it does is, you know, it just, like, scales up the damage, and that's it. And I do kind of agree on what they said about the late game loadout options, so I do approve of this. It's not like all that half bad, but I mean, be sure to let me know what you guys think of this, like, upgrade feature, because I would love to hear your thoughts on this. I do believe this is going to get, like, a lot of mixed feelings. And I do believe every weapon will have the option to be upgraded, and that kind of concerns me a little bit, because think about it. Why would you upgrade useless weapons if you can just upgrade the already good ones to be even better? I guess they will have to, like, figure that out or something, but let's just wait and see what's gonna happen. And now for the last thing, Mrs. Foster. Everyone's favorite character is returning, and I'm just, like, here being like, welp. Not gonna see my cat with the chaw at this rate. So this will be a character from Killing Floor 1, and she will have the voice of Claudia Black. Unlike Dar, this character will be like a DLC, which means you're gonna have to spend money for it, but I mean, I have no idea why they're doing like paid content, because the game already has like microtransactions and shit, but I'm not gonna judge, you know, I'm not the one to judge here, but I'll probably still stick to my Strasser until I get like Kale with the Chaw probably. I mean, I just want Kale with the Chaw, that's pretty much what I want. But everyone apparently wanted Mrs. Foster, so here she comes. Okay, that was pretty much all for the Pathfinder's news on Killing Floor 2's upcoming updates. So I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I'm just going to leave everything that I got the information from in the description, so be sure to check it out. And don't forget to vote on your favorite weapon in the poll. Well, since the game in the background has, you know, still 2 minutes on it, and I just don't want to leave you guys on, you know, the fourth wave in the middle of it, so I'm just going to talk about what I want for this summer. Okay, I'm probably gonna start with what I don't want to see for this, you know, summer update for Killing Floor 2. I don't want another Descent / Holdout styled map. Just get rid of those. Make them once per year. That's a good, like, time, you know, to make a Descent style map, but just don't do it again. Please, I beg of you, they're just not all that fun. And before someone in the comments is going to be like, Pathfinder, you dipstick, why the hell don't you like Descent styled maps? I adore those. I'm just gonna say this again, I don't mind if people like Descent styled maps, I just don't. That's just like my opinion. The only thing I really do wish they would add in the summer update is a huge ass freaking map that has a normal mode and objective mode. Same as they did in Killing Floor 1's Steam Land. Or you know what, they're probably not going to do objective mode this year, they're probably going to do it like next year or something, but If they're not going to do objective mode, at least make a huge-ass freaking map, or should I say like Zedlanding 2.0, where you can actually go like on top of the volcano and shit. I mean, how cool would that be? Like, in a huge-ass map, the only problem with that would be like the trader or something, but... I mean, they can probably find a way to, you know, open the trader that is like closest to the player, but I don't know if they'd refuse to make big maps because of like... optimization purposes, but I really do wish for a huge ass freaking map. But yeah, I'll talk about this in the future news update videos that I'm going to make. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. I'm just going to leave you with the boss battle here, and I hope you guys enjoyed this, and we can discuss things in the comments. So be sure to voice your opinions, because I do read each and every comment, because that's like the best part of YouTube. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed. Leave a like, subscribe, and links in the description. Adios. Come and get your tools of trade. More Zeds on the scope. Back to it, mes amis.